Okay. Hello, students. Today's lesson is about trying to see two different functions. Do you see there is a function PT and there is a function QT, yes or no? Do you see there is a function PT, yes or no?
Yeah.
And what is the meaning of a function? There is input, output. Mm-hmm. So where every time you plug in T, which is input, and you get some answer to it, which is called output, agree?
Yeah, output.
And that's why we call a function where you get Y values for X. So usually we use X, Y all the time. But this one I use T. Can somebody tell me why did I use T?
For time.
How do you know it is time?
Because it's like they're studying growth of bacteria each hour. An hour is time.
Time. Yeah. Perfect. Very good observation.
Thank you.
So the camera will give you 5 points for this, for that good answer. Okay? Okay, next is, thank you, sir. See, this is what I want you guys to do. Oh, you see the T, because you see the reason is hour, right? The time. Perfect. Then the question is, why did I use P and why did I use Q? Usually in the function, what are the letters being used, you know, earlier? All the algebra one, you know, we used to use some function notation. Do you remember what we used to use?
X.
Yeah, X and what else?
Y.
So X, Y. Is there another, we used to write something Y equals, do you remember what it was? Anybody remember? Gulam? Do you start? No. Okay. So this was another, usually all the time, it was always used what? F of X to this.
Yeah.
That's the normal way of saying function, because the function starts with what letter?
F.
That's the only reason. You could use PX, QX, whatever stupid letter. NX, N could be used for number of like people or whatever, population P, or the distance D, you know, all those letters are being used just for what are we describing, talking about, right? Temperature T. The temperature you can use with the time, hours passed by from night time. So those kind of things. Okay, let's go back directly. Am I making sense so far?
Yes.
Got it, right? So look at this. So the question is, by just looking at it, what do you notice? And what do you wonder? Think over this 30 seconds. Just don't say nobody, say nothing. Just think, what do you see in this two expression? I call this expression right now, and then after that we say something else.
Sorry,
I can't pause the video, but still you can think 30 seconds. I wish I could do that like that. Another 20 seconds, somebody must be writing, thinking. Just write in your notebook, scribble a little. I observe, maybe I notice something. And you may be like, maybe wondering is like, must be thinking, what is this? Okay. Can you discuss quickly? Just 5 seconds, talk to your partner maybe. Just, what do you think? Bania, and you can talk to him. Whatever you wrote maybe, you can share. Okay, we can talk as a group, is better? Okay, since we are small group, we can talk. Yeah, let's start with, yeah, who would want to share?
Cassandra.
Okay, Cassandra, what were you thinking of the notice?
Oh, you had a really good idea, Jesus.
What was the idea?
Desiree gave something.
Yeah, you can share what Desiree said. That's good, that's all we were. You discuss and then somebody speaks for someone else. That's okay. Juliana, would you like to say?
I think
wait, Mr. You didn't let Desiree say it. She was ready.
Yeah, she was ready.
I'm so sorry.
No, it's not. Give her $5.
Okay. $5 just to pass Brian. Okay, that's the retail. What did you say?
The second equation, another it's 50 multiplied by e.
So in the second, you observe that in the second equation, that's equation equal, right, or function, whatever. Mm-hmm. In the second one, you see multiplied by e. Okay, what else? Very good. Anything else?
On the second one, the zero, it has a 0.15.
That's one very, very good. I put a color for it, okay? Let me put a color. So instead of 0.15 black color, let me use what? 0.1. Do you see this something? So you see that number, right? Do you see this number? On that one?
No. I see 1.50, but it's not on the tip.
Not maybe the exact number, something similar. Jacob, can you tell? Okay, think of, I'll put this color, this one, I'll put a, this part, I'll put 0. At least now you can see the green color somewhere. Guillermo, do you see this green digits 1, 5? Where do you see?
Wait, what?
Look at this green color 1, 5.
Mm-hmm. It's right there,
so. Yeah, it's right there. Can you see what's that?
0.15.
So I'm gonna put this color. Let me. There is a reason I'm writing this 1 and 5. Okay. So one observation could be, hey, Ribello, there could be. Then the decimal part is the same here. Can you see the decimal part here? 0.15? And here the exponent, what multiplies t, there's a 0.15. Agree?
Yes.
Does anybody know what is the meaning of 0.5 means? What do you think this is? Something in percentages maybe. Remember, so this is our, if I write 0.15, it's same as 0.15 divided by 1, agree? Nobody saying yes?
Yes.
Correct, right? So that means if I multiply both sides by 100, divide, what do you get? What is the top number going to be? 0 at the top? No, you're multiplying 100 to that. You have a calculator. If you get confused, you just multiply it, you can see what you get. What is 0.15 times 100? 0.15 multiplied by 100. Do we need calculator for this?
No.
Why we don't need?
Because it's self-explanatory.
Yeah, it shifts. When we have two zeros, where does the decimal moves? Two places,
to the right.
That's all. You don't have to use calculator. I'm saying.
I'm just making sure.
Okay. And the bottom, what is the bottom part? And what does this mean? Correct. Anything strikes you now? Of course. This one also is the same thing, right? You have a 0.15. What are we talking about? What problem is this? Guillermo. What is the problem talking about?
Bacteria.
Yeah, bacteria, but who is working on it?
Scientist,
what is he doing? Studying, right? The growth of what?
Bacteria.
So what is the growth rate? So what is this called? Growth rate every hour. Make sense? Nobody's. So this 15%. So basically what I want you to write here, this PET, the first one, the PET, let's write down, PET, write down everybody PET, equals PT equals, it's 50, what is this 50? I forgot, what is that 50 stands for? And I'm sorry, I'm going to ask you, what, and I put a color coding, can you see that, orange color? Anybody would like to say what must be this? And I want you to think of the all the time, the exponential function y equals that a times b raised to, do you remember this? Exponential function, that what is a and what is b? How we forget this? There was a chart earlier, we forget, and I don't know where the chart is right now. Anybody remember what is this a stand for? In this formula, we call it also f of x, exponential function. What is the first number stands for? If I make a table like this, and I write x and f of x, what is that all the time? You must be checking my videos also that I made. What is that first thing I put there?
Zero.
Correct? So in the beginning, the scientist, he observes, how many are there? Raising that now? 15. In the beginning, that's all it is. In the beginning, that means even if you are graphing, let's see what we find. So if I want to make a graph like this, so it means in the beginning, let's say this was 50, that's 50. Do you get it? So in the beginning it is 50, and then now I'm going a little slow. The reason is because when I post this, there are some students who want to get the whole idea exactly, everything, okay? I could have just finished it fast like this. But so I make a 50 right here maybe, and then something is happening. See that graph? Exponential graph. So in this example, both expression, the 50 is the first, it means in the beginning, there were how much bacteria was there? Okay? Nobody saying yes or no. And then I put 1 and 2 hours, 3 hours, and so on. Make sense? So in the beginning it is 50, and then what does this one, what is 1.15 stands for? So now I wrote, okay, 50 times, this basically means it is 1 plus 0.15 raised to t. Can you write this step? Okay, so again I repeat, this is x equals 0, or it is 0 times 0, a, this is the, a is the beginning, it's the output. When x is 0, the output is 0. Or in other words, it's where it starts. In this example, it is 0, 50. Do you agree? 0, 50? Mm-hmm. That's where it starts. So lowercase a in the formula, this formula that we know earlier, is what 50 is. And the growth, so there are two words I want you to get, is the meaning of growth rate and growth factor. So this number that you see here, so I want you to put underline again, say this is growth factor. Do you see how it is? Nobody's saying yes.
Yeah.
Growth factor means every time, what do you multiply? For this case is, each time you multiply 1.15, is that okay? So every time you multiply, so there is a growth rate is 15%, but growth factor is 1. Camilla, can you pick the phone? I was supposed to, yeah, they were supposed to send me a $100,000 check. I hope that's the
class.
She's smiling.
Just
dang, I can't even pause my phone. Okay.
Just
my wife. No, you can't do that.
Just end it and
then
come
to. But then please separate two. It doesn't matter. Was my wife. Okay, I'll just finish this. This is easy. What I wanted to show you. Thank you so much. I appreciate you guys are focused. I can see so many eyes lighting up, little, at least, if not everything. At least, oh, okay. With that, at least we know where it starts, right? Then you know what multiplies. Do you agree what multiplies here? It means this part which you see here, that's called growth factor. Can you say that? Growth factor. Everybody say
growth
this?
Factor.
Growth factor.
It means what multiplies. Growth rate is a different word. See this part, this is a different word. Can you see this? Rate means percentage increase. At what percent every hour it grows. Is that okay, Star? And now, this one, I just wanted to why separate it to show that's the same thing I'm talking about. Can you see this part? Nobody saying yes or no? 0.15, 0.15, the same thing. Percent increase, okay? On growth rate. And finally, the question arises is, this one is, it gives, tells you T, this T is, so we want to know what is the bacteria after 3 hours, 4 hours, one and a half hour, whatever it is. But the thing is, this rate which is shown is for each increase of 1 hour. Can you see again, you multiply 1.15. Again, each time you multiply 1.15, is that okay?
Mm-hmm.
That's every hour. But what does this mean? So what does this mean is different. So where did this E come from? The question is, if you remember, E is 2.718. Do you remember this E? We did in the decimal.com, you put the function. Did you remember putting 1 over 1 over x raised to x? Do you remember this thing? Nobody remembers? You posted even in the Google Classroom. We put the graph, we saw that this graph, as x become very large number, this goes something like this. Remember that?
Yeah.
And this is a horizontal asymptote, which is y is 2.718, which means this kind of form, that this is E, got it? So it means it comes very closer to the number 2.718. So what is the difference you see here is, the growth rate here is, sorry, the growth factor here is only this much, correct? Can someone tell me what is the growth factor here for this one? When the bacteria is growing continuously, not 1 hour, what did I say? Every minute, every second, every moment, so it grows. So this basically means bacteria growing continuously. It means every moment. Can you write this one word? Very important. So we must know, when do we use that formula? And when do we use this formula? Okay? So this every. So this is every moment, continuously. Not just every hour, but every minute, every second, every fraction of a second also. Do you get what I said? Even like little fraction also. You know, 1 second is even split into, the digital devices show even 0.001 like that. Okay, my goal here is to say is, this is the final part and we are done, okay? What is the growth factor here? Whoever tells me gets $10. Now gambling.
0.15?
Think over at least 30 seconds. My question, listen to me. My question is, everybody understood the growth factor is 1.15, yes or no? You saw the table how every time multiplied. That's all the growth factor. My question is, in this case, if it is 50 times e raised to 0.15, what is the growth factor?
E.
Okay, I'll clean this off so that you can clearly see. $10 are gone, so I can't give. Still, I can give. Okay, watch again. So, what is the growth factor here? Start. What is the growth factor here? This is not clear. Can you just compare with that one on here? How do we get growth factor? This is the trapezoid type. T has to be lonely. Alone. So the rest is the growth factor, agree? Yes or no? This part is growth factor, yes? Likewise, can you get here? $20. That's the lesson actually. When we spend a little more time, the lesson is about, can a student identify the growth factor there and the growth rate, at what percent it is growing the bacteria? What was in the beginning?
Yeah, I don't know the answer.
Then it is $1. I'm just kidding.
She said it's E.
Okay, so she's saying E. Okay, I take it. But my question is E. If you say E, the T stays by itself? Remember the growth factor, how do we figure out? It has to be whatever that number raised to T. Do you see that T? T is by itself. Can you try now at least? You were almost there.
It's 0.15. Because you said T has to be by itself.
Wow.
Desiree saying, yeah, that's correct.
Are you saying?
Growth factor.
Are you?
Correct, right? Start, did you get it? Now, so first one thing is.
Was that right?
My God. Yeah, you're right? But listen, I can't give you $20, I can give you 10 because I give you the clue, right? But if you had to really give without my thing, okay, it is in Mr. DiBello, it is this. E raised to 0.15, that's it. Oh, my $10. Oh, no, no. Go inside. Oh, no. That's your. Thank you. No, no, that's why you.
I'll take it.
That's for you. Oh, my thing is, it's just a reward from my side, like my daughter has a lot of soda. Yeah, she deserves it, man. What? Okay, I'm finishing. We are done, okay? So finally, what I'm going to do is, I'll make you to watch one more video clip. Why? No, you guys are not watching. Okay, she is excited. That's all, the money is given. Done, finish. And once we are done, we can have a little fun, maybe 5 minutes, and then I'll tell you what to do. But let's finish this, okay? Watch. My goal here is, that's what it was in the beginning. That's the growth factor. That's the percent increase, 25%. Do you see what I'm talking about? A lot of the characteristic of the exponential function. And when it comes to like this way, almost everything is same, But the growth factor is different. Look at this thing. Now on your calculator, I want everybody to use the yellow calculator, or you can use your phone. Directly pull out your phone, take the calculator. I want you to do this, e raised to 0.15. What do you get? So I want you to do, on your calculator, put a E. I think on your scientific calculator it should be, not the, if it's on your phone, it has to be scientific. Use the yellow calculator. Everybody quick.
Who needs one?
Who needs calculator? Because all of you should get that, and that's the main conclusion. I'm making a conclusion, Casagrande. That's where I stayed 6 years. I stayed in Casagrande 6 years. You know,
Mr. Grande.
Grande, yeah. Can we finish now? So, everybody, fine. What is 0.15? Please help me. Put it on the calculator and see what you have. Having fun, Guillermo? Okay, let's ask. Guillermo is one of my best students. Guillermo, tell me, what did you get?
Yeah, 19.39.
Are you sure you get 19?
Do you want to give me like full number?
But my question is, do you get this one, 19 point? Jacob, check your calculator. No, I will just want to make sure, because I have something in my mind. Let me also do as you guys do. It is E raised to. So on my calculator, there's already second. You click on the second, and there's a log between log and ln, and put 0.15.
Did you get?
Yeah, it's not 90. Check it again. What did you get, Jesus?
Wait, what did you get?
Challenging, Mr. Bell. Let's ask Star. Star, tell me.
If it's something with
1.49. 1.461. 1.49 you got?
Mm-hmm.
How many of you got 1.61?
I just said
8, 3, 4, 2, 4, 3. Agree? Okay, very good. Most of you. If you can, I'll show you later on individually if somebody gets. Camilla. Camera. Okay. So this means this is the growth. What is this called? Growth factor, because you are calculating your check. The bacteria is growing, continuous growth is checked. Not just hour. It could be minutes, seconds, every moment. So this answer is 1 plus. Please write down this last conclusion. 0.1618. I'm gonna skip this. I'll use the 4 place decimal. This means the R, which is the growth rate, which is also percent increase. So the percent increase is now, this is 0.16818. Can we write in the percentage? What is that in percentage? How many places do I move this decimal?
4.
So the growth rate is 0.1618, which is same as 16.18 divided by 100, and that is 16.18%. Do you see that? Nobody's saying yes or no. So which growth rate is bigger, on the left side or the right side? You saw the growth rate here. What was the growth rate here? 15%. What did we get now? 16 point something. It means if you use this formula, the bacteria is really going to showing more value. So the main ending here is the graph. See how the graph will look like now. Of course, we will do the dashboard also and see. So if this is the case, everybody knows this one, two. Last sketch of the graph. And let's say this is 50, 100, 150, 200, 250. So this is where the graph goes. So this one I'm gonna use maybe a orange color PT. I'm not taking the exactly, but it will be something like this. That's it. I could figure out for 1, 2, 3, 4 and get the point, but the idea is, oh, that's how the sketch is. Now because this one is growth factor is 1.16, growing percent increase is 16, it's higher than 15%. So what happens to the graph is, this graph in the beginning, let me use a green color. So in the beginning, they are almost the same, but as hours progress, then it goes like this. Do you see that? Because of that percent more. So when the growth rate is higher, they start at 50, but the orange color is the PT, and the green color is this one, QT graph. You can put it on the desmos.com and you can clearly see, you will see that each time this point will be like this. See, every hour, like this, let's say 4 hours, the green one is higher. The difference is more as you progress with more hours, then you'll see the difference is more. The population of the bacteria, initially it may be less, okay, and the higher the percentage, like this one is just 0.15% here. So 15% means you don't see much of a difference. If you take a 5%, that it doesn't, it's almost the same thing. 1%, 2%, 3%, 4%, it will be almost similar, but when it is like 15%, 20%, you see there is a difference between the two graphs like that. Is that okay? So what I'm gonna do is the next is, where the hell this formula come from? Why did we put, so next part is, now the question is, who gave us this? Who told us to put like this? Why did this E come from? Do you see what I'm saying? So the question is, why did E use you? You get what I'm saying? And in order for this, we know the answer E is 2. We do know E is 2.7180, but why did we use it here? And therefore that I will give you the link to check that, where you write those notes, take a picture and post. Is that okay? So hope, as I end this, what is one thing you learned from this 30 minutes? Anybody, what did we learn? So what is there something you learned from here?
The growth rate.
The growth rate, what else?
The percentage.
Percent rate. You can say percent increase, or you say growth rate and growth factor. Two different things. Remember, this is growth factor, got it? But when you write 0.15, that's growth rate. Make sense? 15%. So always remember the difference. And one more thing is, when you try to calculate the bacteria population continuously every moment, then you will see the bacteria's population will be higher at any moment. Let's say 4 hours, the bacteria for the green graph will be higher, more bacteria than the one that is used, because this is 15% and that is 16 something. Is that okay? Nobody's saying yes. Cassandra, is that okay? Okay, so now pull out your laptop. Everybody pull out your laptop. And in the laptop,